Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're gonna see how to quickly and easily create these scan effects that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. Alright, so let's go and open Photoshop. And then I'm gonna press Ctrl Command N to create a new document. And I will put 4500 for the width and 3000 for the height. And I will change the resolution to 300. The resolution. And I will press OK. Alright, so this will be a very straightforward and easy effect to do. And I'm gonna do it using Smart Object, because it's always good to have the option to go back or maybe to reuse the PSD if you want. Alright, so I'm gonna create a new layer and I will name it image 1, and then I'll right click, convert it to smart object. I always like to delete this background in here, and then I will right click again and edit content, and this will allow me to open it in a new tab. And then I will go to my folder. As you can see, I have a bunch of images that it will match the effects. So let's go with this one that is smashed with the glass or crushed with the glass. All right, so I will keep it like that and I will close this and I will make sure to press yes to save the changes. And there we go, we have our image saved in our smart objects. All right, next I will go to actually filter, and I will choose filter gallery, and I will press Ctrl to go back to the default. All right, and always, as I said, make sure that you have the default colors is black and white set to the default by pressing D on your keyboard. All right, so we're gonna apply two effects from here. Now there are other options, or there are other ways to achieve the same effects using other filters, but for this tutorial I will go with a simple one, a grain. And the idea of this grain is to boost the contrast, as you can see, for us to have that really nice photocopy or a scan effect in here. And for the intensities, depend on your image, you can go as up as you want or as high as you want. For me, I think I will stick in the 50 range, between 50 and 60. And then I will press on this plus icon to add a new filter. Then I will go to sketch and I will choose tone edges. And there, and this will turn our image to black and white. Now, again, it's depend on your image. I think for this one, I will keep the image balance to 25. But for the contrast, I think I will put it down a little bit because I still want some of these features to be shown, just like this. And let's actually play with the smoothness. Yeah, we'll keep it around 10. And image balance. You know, just play with the sliders and then you will end up with something that you want. I mean, I think I will stick with 27. And that will be all for this filter gallery. And I hope it's okay. Alright, so we're almost like there, we are halfway to our effect. Now, I will duplicate this image by pressing Ctrl Command J or this smart object, and I will call this blur. And then I will go back to filter, and this time I will go for blur, and I will choose motion blur. Now, it depends on the resolution of your image. The distance, it will depend on that. For me, I have a very, like, a fair quality documents in here, so I will put the distance for like 220, and I will press OK. It's supposed to have that motion blur, but we're not gonna keep it like that. We're gonna actually apply a line mask, and then I will go to the gradient in here, the gradient tool, and I will make sure to choose the reflected gradient in here. And also I have the gradient set to color to transparent. So while I'm having black as my foreground color, I will go in the center and I will one click and I will press shift and I will drag like that. Maybe I will redo it and I will make it smaller. Maybe I will add a little bit in here, and that's exactly what I want. All right, perfect. As you can see. All right. Now we only need to add our textures. So I will go and open the two textures that I will make sure to put for you guys to download. And by the way, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like for this video. And yeah. All right. So let's go and open the first texture. So I will drag it directly in here. As you can see, this is a scan texture. And by the way, for the Patreon family, I will make sure to upload like a horizontal and vertical pasty for you guys with maybe more scan textures. So yeah, you will find it down in the link from the description below. And thank you very much for your support. All right, now I will change this to, let's go for either screen or lighten. For me, I will keep it screen. So I think it's a little bit heavy. So while I'm selecting this, I'm gonna press Ctrl Command L to open the level adjustment. That will play with the highlights and the shadows, because I'm only interested in this area. So yeah, something like that. I think it looks really interesting. Perfect. Now we'll go back and open the other texture. It's like that. It gets bigger. And again, I will change the blending mode of this to screen. Yeah, let's go with screen. And again, I'm going to press Ctrl Command L. And I will play with midtones and highlight. All right. I think I like how it looks. Now it's depend on you. You can actually lower the opacity and the fade if you want. But for me, I think I would keep it like that. And now let's actually apply this using another image. So to do that, you can just choose one of those two smart objects. Right click and edit content. Let's choose an image. So let's go for something like this one. Why not? And let's actually make it a little bit bigger to have that same scan effect, just like that. All right, and then I will close it and I will make sure to press yes to save the changes. And I will wait for it to progress. And there we go. We have a person that it looks like it's in a scanned texture or a scanned photocopy. All right, cool. So let me go back to the other one and that will be our effect. So I hope that you enjoy and you liked this tutorial and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment and you know what's for more to come. And let me know if you have any ideas for the next video. And have a nice day. Thank you for watching.